Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Crash Team Racing. So, yes, we are back, and we, in the last part, we took down Komodo Joe? No, we didn't. We got the remaining CTR coins and freaking relic raises. Like, what am I talking about here? Oh, man. So, anyway, yes, in this part, we'll be tackling the fourth or third world of the game. I believe it's the fourth. Yeah, it is the fourth world of the game, so let's get on to that, shall we? And I actually have an interesting tale to tell you all that happened to me today that I thought would be worth noting. So, gather around the computer, children! Yankee's gonna tell a story! And if you go up here, there's a save portal. And, yep, 66% of completion. I just wanted to make a note of that. Yay for satanic messages! But anyway, like I was saying, I've got a story for you all! Alright, so something that happened to me today that was rather interesting was I experienced something for the first time of my life. And no, it's not what you're thinking. It's not sex. But anyway, oh my god, I'm just ridiculous right now. But anyway, yes, what I experienced today was something a guy should experience once in his lifetime, I would say. At least once. I don't know. It's pretty frowned upon in the guy society, but I had my first facial today. Yes, I am such a man. I feel so manly right now. I feel like Chuck Norris would. Then again, Chuck Norris didn't get facials. Facials get Chuck Norris. But anyway, like I was saying, it just, I don't know. I have really dry skin for some reason on my face. I've been going there for the past year for that, whatever, for treatments and stuff. So, I actually got a facial finally, and it was actually pretty good. I don't know. It felt relaxing. It took like a half hour. It was not as painful as I... Actually, it was more painful than I thought it would be. I thought it would be more, a bit more relaxing and less painful and soothing, but it was a little painful, but pretty soothing on the... Yes, soothing pain right there. But yeah, it was actually pretty cool, and they played the music in the background. And it was actually one of the weirdest experiences I've actually ever had in my life. It's definitely in the top 10 of weirdest experiences I've ever had. I don't know. Just the whole like way it happened, the experience, I don't know. It was just wacky and weird nonetheless. So I just got back from that, and you know what? I feel great right now. I'm not doing fine. I feel great. But you know, actually it was pretty nice. And how's time still ahead of me? I gotta take this guy out. I gotta focus on the rice! The rice again. Oh wow, I hit him twice. Cool, nice. Cool, nice. Okay. I guess when you get a facial, it brings out the best of you or the worst of you. Yeah, I did find 66. Oh, I got a bolt on that. Nice. If you put stuff inside of that turbo cycle right there, it's actually like if you have a nice nitro crate or TNT, it's pretty good because it's more than likely that there's going to be a grouping inside of there. So if you get a nice nitro barrel, you can get more than one targets out there, one or more people killed. So that's pretty cool. This is actually one of the cooler design courses at Engine Labs. That was pretty cool. And whoa, okay, we got a boost of people right there. That was kind of weird. You son of a Coco! Fifth place? I'm not even, like, doing bad. That was my one fudge up in fifth place. Wow, this game is pretty unfreaking. Okay, I can't waste these. And I'm not gonna waste them. I'm trying to get Coco and Dingo. The Dingo that did not eat my baby. Alright, so let's get Coco here. Can I get her? Nice, okay, so good. I was rationing out my rockets right there. Of course, the one guy didn't hit to the first place. Tiny. Tiny once again. Trying to make him small. I'm setting to Wumbo. I keep on making that joke. The Mumbo and Wumbo joke in SpongeBob. I gotta stop that. Alright, let's see if I can get this inside here. Ooh, that's pretty nice. Should I actually use that now? I'm gonna hold off until. Oh, whoa. Holy dab inside here. Ooh, that's pretty nice. Should I actually use that now? I'm gonna hold off until. Oh, whoa. Holy dab. Because in case someone gets in front of me, I can take out two as opposed to one, so. Definitely a strategy there. You have to be there. Oh, whoa, what the? Okay, it had a target on me for some reason. Shoot that backwards. Oh, I got Dingo! I'm getting so lucky today. Thank God I got a facial. Thank God I got a facial, LeFleur. But too bad White doesn't know that facials are good. Facials are good at getting served to you. Yes. Really not making sense right now. But anyway, let's coast our way to victory. Do another boost right there. And there we go! Wow, okay, we actually had a pretty closer, tight-knit race right there. For some reason, I wasn't really making any mistakes, but then again, I was talking about the story, and obviously it took a lot of my concentration out of me playing. One of the drawbacks of doing live commentary, but you know what? Everyone loves live commentary, and in the game. Oh wow, actually I had one of the advanced races be in both the second and third slots. Pretty cool. And back to the world we're in. We're actually in like a castle area. It's actually one of my favorite worlds of the game because of not only the look of it, but with the levels. Like that level we just did, Engine Labs, is pretty cool. I think we have access to it. No, we don't yet, okay. And don't look at that thing. We're not gonna be racing that later. We actually have to find out where we're gonna race next. It's actually over here. It's actually upstairs, maybe. This area can actually be pretty tough to navigate. It's down on the left. Yep, there it is. Okay, it's Cortex Castle. Okay, so we're getting a lot of bad guy stages. Pretty much the theme of this world. I don't really think there's any good guy stages because, I don't know, castle, you directly associate that to evil. Come on, what evil henchman doesn't have a castle as a lair? Even the Ice King does. Where's an ice castle? Nice castle. Okay, I had to do that. Alright. So let's just see here. 8th place. Let's boost our way to 2nd. What a chip. Come on. 3rd. 4th. 5th. 6th. Come on. Not playing that bad. And we got spiders. Alright, we gotta watch out for them. And obviously we have different routes right here. They're both the same because they're both leading to the same point. You gotta figure that out. But yeah, a lot of gimmicks in this place like you saw before. The spiders. Oh, you stole my item for you, bastard. But like I would say, if you knock into the spiders, you wipe it out. It's like a banana, basically. Whoa! And it's like that, basically, as well. So we definitely don't want to run into them, but usually they're put in front of, like, areas where you get these item chests and stuff, so... Gotta watch out for them. And that was perfect timing to get that. Actually, we take out most of the people, and it took out Crash. Cool. Like, I really don't understand the thing with that. It's not a Blue Koopa Shell, but it doesn't take out everyone in its path. So I'm kind of curious if it's at random that it kills someone, or just gets, like, every other person in first place. I probably have to look into that. Maybe I'll add an annotation right here to show if that's true or not. But, oh well, we may never know. What the hell? What the hell? First of all, that bomb exploded midair, and I just got rid of that 2D, thank God. Alright, so let's take out Tiny, and I missed. Don't wipe, I missed. And let's get this great. Oh, what? I went right through. Getting really no one's praise in this race. Yeah, but luckily I have 10 berries, so, oh well. No harm, no foul. What the hell?! Dude! How'd that go backwards?! Are you kidding me?! I think Crash shot that, and it went backwards and it hit me. I've never seen that. It actually led to... That's actually a pretty good discovery right there. There should be rockets that go backwards, but then again, we have projectiles that go backwards, but... Crash, you hack! You're a cheater! You're cheating at this game. Cheating at your own game, nonetheless, and let's just destroy that. I know I should have left that for someone else, but whoa, nice shot right there. But I want to destroy it just to get out of my way. Hey, what do you know? Cortex is in first place in his own area. You don't see that so often. I don't know if that's intentional or not, but oh well. Let's see if we can make up some ground here. A bomb! I actually didn't mean to shoot at that. I thought it was a rocket for some reason. It went in my head. Oh, nice. Crash rock crashed into the spider. Okay. Name is Sumanix. Alright, so we're in second place. Wow, this actually is a pretty hard roll when you think of it, because you're actually, if you race what you're doing now, or you race it normally, it's pretty hard to actually get in first place. Definitely a sign of things to come. Hopefully not, actually. Alright, so we got Crash in our way right here. Let's see if we can get some, lucky with getting some items here. Yeah, unfortunately, your racing skills alone aren't good enough to win some of these races, and you actually have to rely on items, which is kind of sucky, but... Yeah, well, they give you the item crates, might as well use them. Oh, that actually came in handy, that's awesome. Imagine getting some Mario Kart, that would be freaking frowned upon times 10. That would never happen. They would pretty much just do it as a star in second control, but... Now we got the times 10 berries, so we get for twice as long, so that was great. That was actually a perfect timing to get that. Now we have a pretty comfortable lead, so we can... Oh, nice. Drop that right there. If someone lands on that... I don't know, it's actually if you stop on the ramp and you go backwards there, I don't know. Alright, so we turned a close race into a not even close race. Okay. We cut that out, that 59 seconds, 106, 107 average. Cool. So we got lucky in that race with getting that mask, but you know what? I'll take the luck. Just like the Colts are going to take Andrew Luck first pick overall, but that's talking about football. I don't listen to that in LP, come on. Who talks about sports and LPs? Even though I follow them daily. Oh man, so anyway, yes, first place in Pura and Cortex. Okay, Cortex came in third. At least he placed in his own race, or in his own track.
Congratulations.
All right, so that's two races in the bag. And, ooh, yes, we actually go to the next world, the next level, which is Hot Air Skyway, my favorite level of the game. Actually, I can't really say favorite level. Is it my favorite level? Because I never like to declare something as my favorite unless I, like, look at all the races together. I'm just making a general statement right here, but you know what? This actually is one of my favorite worlds because the design of it's cool. You got different areas you can access by doing different things. We'll get into it as we race along. As you can see, we have the boss logo all over this map, so yeah, if you put two and two together, we'll be seeing this level definitely once again in a boss race type of format. So that's actually pretty cool. I get to do a boss race in my favorite level, so that's pretty cool. We got, like, Zeppelins over here, like Led Zeppelins. Unfortunately not, but Zeppelins nonetheless. I definitely gotta get a boost here. Okay, this is actually the part that you can take a shortcut if you go right, but it's really risky in doing, and if you miss, you're pretty much gonna go in 8th place because it takes a while for them to pick you back up and race to put you back on the track. It'll put you back on the ramp, I believe so. Definitely a time waster, but it's a shortcut, so if you get it and you hit it on the knock, you hit it right on the target, I should say, you know, knock. I make up phrases all the time, I swear to God. If you hit it on the target, then you should be in pretty much first place, so, high risk, high reward, actually, high risk, high reward, low risk, low reward. So let's see if we put it that way. Nice, we get some people out here. And it's actually a tight racetrack, so you should be getting a lot of these things. Another one, cool, I'll take it. I think that's how it works. If it's, like, tighter and everyone's grouped together, it maybe hits more. I don't know, I don't know. And we got a lot of tight turns, and this racetrack is as well, too, so definitely one we gotta look at, make a note of that as well. We get tiny, okay, good, I thought it was gonna run out, but luckily I got it in the nick of time. We have a nice TNT wall right there. Okay, tiny guy, but how did Coco and Ninja do that? That was kind of cool. You see them jocking for a second. Alright, we got a bomb here, that's actually pretty good. Right. Stop! What, they went? Oh no! I got it! Holy crap! And Dingle got two! What? Ferg is in second place. God, I thought I was gonna be on my own with that. But you have to, like, basically with that jump, it's a weird, really weird jump to make because you have to jump at the exact perfect time in order to make the jump. Because if you just do the ramp and don't jump, you'll fall. I didn't say it earlier, but I should have said it. Basically, yeah, you have to jump exactly at the right point in the ramp, like right bat, like kind of thing. And it's a weird kind of jump, I don't know, that's why I don't really try it too often. I did that by mistake, which is pretty funny, but definitely not going to try it again, because if you miss the jump, then you're pretty much screwed. Ooh, wow. She almost kamikaze'd me right there. If I didn't have a freaking orb around me, she would have taken that TNT crate with me. That was pretty good. Clutch that I had the blue orb. Or a sphere. And wow, how'd you miss, man? Miss with a rocket? That's pretty weird. Hopefully someone lands on that. This is the last lap. Wow, who's in the last place? Is that Crash? I think he's blue. He's on blue too, but I'm light blue. But I love dark blue. My favorite color is midnight blue. Okay, so let's just finish this race right here, and I'm not going to take the chance. I'm definitely going to go on this side. And it's like a, what, 3-second differential because of the shortcut as opposed to that, so really, if when you come to think of it, it's really not worth the risk because, I don't know, you can pretty much make that up. Right, so we get Coco with this rocket. Oh, she actually avoided the rocket. And okay. Luckily, I had three, so I could take out both of them. Oh, man. I'm feeling so fresh right now. I should be calling me the Freeze Brothers because I'm feeling so fresh. Okay. I don't know why I threw out a freaking other way. Runaway. Runaway, guys. The other guy's reference right there. I was trying to say my face is feeling so fresh, but obviously, that awkward babble came out for some reason. I have no idea. I find that I'm making a lot of babble here. I don't know, maybe the facial pose is babbling some of my recordings, but I don't know. I think we're doing pretty good right now, and hopefully without any interruptions, we shall be getting first place. There we go. Now, obviously, when you get toward the third lap, you notice that you get your fastest lap on that track, or fastest time on that lap. I've just been seeing a trend there with my lap threes, because typically you have all 10 berries and get a lot of good items and whatnot. Alright, so that's three races in the bag. I'm looking at the time right now. 14:30. Trying to think right here. I don't think we're actually going to get another race in because we're running a bit low on time. We got the two evil scientists right there. Dr. Cortex and Dr. Engine. Why should we call it Tengen? That's like just so, too good of a similarity to pass up. But you know what? I'll just call it Tengen. It's kind of an insult to call it Tengen that, because come on, look at it. He looks like a freak. But anyway, yes, I think we'll have to actually end it off here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed my parts and videos. Oxide Station. Another area we'll be seeing much later in the game again. I wonder what format, though. But anyway, enough of the spoilers. I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. This is Yank, signing out.